Hello, and welcome back to Mass Effect 2. I'm Chance, also known as Maras. In the last episode session thingy, we went and got Grunt, the Krogan. I'm coming up here to feed my fish because, you know what? In one of the side quest episodes, my fish died. I don't want him to die again. I just don't want him to die. So anyways, we're gonna go get the final crew member for this set of dossiers. I should have actually read the dossiers, because I never actually did. So why don't we read it now? Dossier, the convict. No, Jack. No last name. No. You know what? The space words from the side quest episodes messed me up. Jack. No last name known. Exceptional biotic ability. No. Criminal background currently in custody. Jack is rumored to be the most powerful human biotic. Little else is known, but the subject has a history of violence and should be approached carefully. Currently, Jack is being held on the Turian spaceship Purgatory. Cerberus has negotiation for the subject's release. Should have read all those before, you know, go and get all the crew. But you know what? We don't follow the law. Technically, we don't actually, because we're helping known terrorist organization, Cerberus. In the side quest episode, I came and explored everything and found that this place had more quests than the Krogan area. Prison ship Purgatory, owned by the notorious Blue Sun's mercenary company. The Purgatory was once an ark ship used to hold agricultural animals. Now it's used to hold prisoners, whether taken in by battle or sold by unscrupulous politicians under the name of subcontracting and outsourcing. Rumors abound that the Blue Suns turn skilled or fit prisoners over to Batarian slavers, but few have ever seen the transaction and live to tell about it. The population listed is 4,350, but independent journalist estimates it's nearly three times that in periods of overcrowding. Well, lots of convicts etching to get their point across. Could end up captured by the enemy. Gonna take the dream team, which is Grunt and our boy Garrus. His sniper rifle's been wrecking them. I could take Zaid, he also has a sniper rifle, but Garrus is my boy. Also gonna change this to the Vindicator, because, hot damn, is that assault rifle good? I'm unfortunately gonna change it back to my favorite, the collector rifle. No real reason besides the fact that it's fun. Grunt, I've also given you a collector, and the Krogan shotgun. The one-shot wonder. Here we go, on another adventure to get what we want. That's all low res. It's supposed to be at high res. I guess in certain situations it won't be as high res as they'd like it to be. Prison guard.
Welcome to the Purgatory, Shepard. Your package is being prepped and you can claim it shortly. As this is a high security vessel, you need to relinquish your weapons before we proceed.
I can't do that.
Everyone stand down. Commander, I'm Warden Kirill, and this is my ship. Your weapons will be returned on the way out. You must realize this is just a standard procedure.
It's my standard procedure to keep my gun.
Especially when dealing with Blue Suns.
Let them proceed.
Killed a lot of them.
Our facility is more than secure enough to handle three armed guests. Mm-hmm. We're bringing Jack out of cryo. As soon as the fund's clear, you can be on your way. If you'll follow me to out-processing for the pickup, Commander.
Let's go.
Seems like a standard come and collect deal.
Cell block 2. As you can see, we keep tight control over the population.
Not bad.
Each prisoner's cell is a self-contained modular unit. I've blown a few out the airlocks as an example.
Wow.
The ship is made up of 30 cell blocks identical to this
one. Kill people for
one.
No fucking reason.
We house thousands of criminals.
I mean, they are criminals, but...
We can put the whole place in lockdown on a moment's notice.
Not bad. More
Nothing
interested in that assault
here.
Rifle on your back, because I kind of want that. Tell me about
can
Jack.
Can you tell me about Jack?
Cerberus hasn't told you? Jack is the meanest handful of violence and hate I've ever encountered. Dangerous, crazy, and very powerful. You'll see soon enough.
Just like our good boy Grunt right
How'd
here.
How'd you end up running this ship?
I was in law enforcement on Palavin and got sick of seeing criminals escape out into the galaxy to carry on with their crimes. Bounty hunters aren't dependable. Eventually, I hit upon this idea. Keep the criminals in space, and the galaxy is a safer place.
You do this because you think it's necessary?
I mean...
Every day I see the worst
pretty efficient.
Life has to offer. Governments are soft, unwilling to make the hard choices. Someone had to stand up and make the galaxy safe.
Oh. Did I...
How'd you end up running this ship?
Yeah, I already...
I was in law enforcement on Palavin and got sick of seeing bounty hunters. Eventually, I hit upon this idea. Keep the criminals in
Maintaining a population this size in space can't be cheap.
Yeah.
We can cut corners that governments can't. And each prisoner brings in a fee from his homeworld. These individuals are violent, and their home planets pay well to keep them here.
What happens if the homeworld doesn't want to pay?
We explain that we can't maintain the prisoner without their help. So we'll be forced to release him back onto his homeworld. At an unspecified place and time.
Scare the homeworlds with the prisoners.
You don't have to agree with my methods, but don't question my motives. These are despicable people, and I'm keeping them locked up.
Let's get on with this.
I bet people try pretty hard to get out.
We're in space. They have nowhere to go, and they know it. But still, we exercise extreme caution. These are dangerous individuals.
Ooh.
We have many ways to control the population.
Nice toys.
I'm going to confirm that the funds from Cerberus cleared. Our processing is straight down this hallway. Just keep going past the interrogation rooms and the Supermax wing.
All right. Seems pretty simple.
I'll catch up with you later, Shepard.
Well, seems pretty effective. They are basically...
You don't even get good information. After a point, victims admit to anything to make the pain stop.
Is that necessary?
Is there something I can do for you?
There's no excuse for beating a prisoner who can't fight back.
This is a massage compared to what his victims went through.
This degrades you as much as him.
We have orders.
You're not important enough to make your own decisions?
I admit, I sometimes get tired of this. Does this really get us anything useful?
Stop this. For your own sake.
Yeah, you're right. Call it off. At least for now.
Changing people's morals one dialogue option at a time.
Hey, if you're buying prisoners, can you buy me? Man, I don't care where you take me or what you do to me. It's gotta be better than this.
Get yourself out. We're here for Jack.
Jack? Forget what I just said. I don't want to go nowhere with you.
What's wrong with Jack?
Tell me more about Jack.
The worst trouble you ever saw. Mixed with some crazy and way too much biotic power. That's all I'm saying.
What's it like here?
Bad. And you gotta watch out. Damn, but someone's always after your stuff. Your smokes, clothes, your pride.
Oh.
I haven't taken a shower in 3 months.
So,
even on
for?
Space prison
I
boats.
A few people. Only about 20 or so. And I blew up that one habitat. Small time compared to most of the guys here.
I wouldn't buy you.
Why are they interrogating
you? Killed 20
that
people.
Prisoner?
I mean,
you know
I killed more, but.
Nah, that's
big. You probably didn't do it
you
for
don't
good.
Know nothing. He offed someone in the showers yesterday, I think. Guy he killed was worth a lot to the warden. Yeah. Sucks to be Bimmy right now.
Do you know? Do they know when to stop?
Going at it pretty hard. Do they ever kill prisoners by accident?
I haven't heard of anyone dying. Warden can't make money off us if we're dead. Funny thing, though. The more a guard does it, the meaner he gets. So they rotate him through.
I mean...
I thought this ship was a prison, not a market.
There's like a psychology.
There's a punishing of their own.
There is a reason for that. I remember learning about it, but I forgot what it's called.
Wish I could go.
I should go. I wish I should go.
I hear the screaming in my head.
You sound like someone from Bioshock. My glasses hurting my nose. I think I need to readjust.
Now processing's through the door on the far side of the room.
Okay.
My apologies, Shepard. You're more valuable as a prisoner than a customer.
The fuck, dude?
Drop your weapons and proceed into this open cell. You will not be harmed.
Maybe I can change your mind.
Activate systems.
I tried. Time to fire.
Heads up! This will slow him down.
Take it!
Good thing we kept our guns, eh? I don't know if this shield upgrade is doing anything, but at least I'm not being completely wrecked. Okay, time to rest. I know when the going gets rough to take a break sometime. My one shot headshot didn't work this time.
This should slow him down.
Rip grunt. I just love the feel of this shot, assault rifle. It's only second to the Geth assault rifle, but you don't get that till later.
We need to get heads up!
Yes, we do. The crazy biotic might be beneficial to our escape. Considering how powerful everyone describes her to be. Never mind, this is way more powerful than the Vindicator, especially since I could hold down the trigger rather than having to click, click, clickety, clack. Insanity I would have died 3 times by now, but alright, Jack, you ready to get out?
That's going to open every door on the cell block.
It's the only way to get Jack out of cryo.
I'm doing it. Be ready.
I won't. Here we go. Not wearing that much clothes, are you?
Jack is small.
Winky thing. I agree.
Warning. Warning.
I want to see how long she can last.
Well, she just took out 4 mechs. I think she could last pretty well. We could barely hold 4 mechs. Actually, we could barely hold 1 mech.
No survivors.
inside a prison room. Damn good.
It's power. She lacks subtlety.
Can I get down from here? Oh, not again. Help me! The glitches! I have Overwatch. I can't get down, can I? Free me from this prison. Help me! Oh well, I gotta reload the goddamn save. Be right back!
Looks interesting.
All guards, restore order. Lethal force authorized. But don't kill Jack. Checks lockdown.
Sectors 7, 9, and 11 have lost life support. No survivors.
Well, hot diggity.
We've been spotted.
Seems I needed to turn all left instead of going straight. You won't open the airlock. Let's all be honest. Front, why aren't you using your incinerator now? Oh, it's not even looking at me. Just lay into him until he decides to turn my way. Oh, he is looking at me. Sniper. Grunt. Shotgun.
Change weapon.
Grunt. Fire shotgun. Me. Fire shotgun as well. There we go. Back to the zone. I would love a VR game of some sort.
The warden has locked down the area behind you. You must find another exit route.
Just
warning.
I love Mass
Effect. Damage has led to overload. Core systems failure imminent.
This guard got swarmed by prisoners with improvised weapons. He never had a chance.
Shows you what kind of people these prisoners are. I don't agree with everything they do here, but it's in the galaxy's best interests.
Well, I mean,
this guard kept maniacs away.
We are literally kind of the bad guys here. Honestly? I mean, if it wasn't for the fact that they tried to kidnap us, I would have totally been fine with what they were doing. As Garrus said, they kept bad people away from bad places. Knock him on his ass.
No survivors.
Is that Jack, by the way? Is she the one doing all those no survivor kills? She's effective, but she needs to calm down a bit. Come on, we can do it. We got my good old fashioned collector of salt rock shredding through these people. We can do this. We're not close enough for this. Any goodies? Some sweet loot? Upgrades? Anything? One. Two. Aw, I shot him in the shoulder. Never mind. Two. As I keep that mech in sight, I could deal with all other ops' positions. Rip the grunt. Oh shit, Garrus, I thought you were the other guy. Come on. Come on. Tactical nuke inbound. Damn it, Garrus, I need you right now! Okay. Efficient enough. God damn it. Where's these shots coming from? Oh. Is that it? Yep.
Any... Find Jack! Full alert! Find Jack!
Any loot that I could use? Doesn't seem to be any loot. Except for that. Is there anything like... up here, maybe? I don't see anything. Well, let's proceed.
All guards to cell block one!
Cell block one. I wasn't sure there for a second. I was like, if I fail, I'm gonna hate myself. Hey, look. Jack's the good guy.
You're valuable, Shepard. I could have sold you and lived like a king.
Who would you sell me to,
But you're too much trouble. At least I can recapture Jack.
Not happening. You're a two-bit slave trader, and I don't have time for it.
I do the hard things civil governments are unwilling to. This is for the good of the galaxy.
Fire in the hole.
Pretty sure there's no loot in this arena. Well, kind of sure.
Fire in the hole.
Grabbing cover.
Boom, boom, boom. Shots on the unguarded one over there.
Back shot.
Come on, Grunt. Take them out. Are you gonna pop your head and say hi? There you go. Not that bad. Gotta say, these side quests have been really beneficial. Rest in peace. Oh, my back. Why are you angry? Got your back.
What the hell do you want?
To rescue. You're in a bad situation and I'm gonna get you out of here.
Shit, you sound like a pussy. I'm not going anywhere with you. You're Cerberus.
So what?
Why does it matter if I'm with Cerberus?
They've been on my ass for years. Anytime I get free, they put a huge bounty on me. That's why Warden Curl figured he'd struck gold when he caught me. It isn't working out too well for him.
I'm the one that let you out.
You show up in a Cerberus frigate to take me away somewhere? You think I'm stupid?
This ship is going down in flames. We can get you to safety and we're asking for your help.
Just shoot her and patch her up on the ship.
I'd like to see you try.
We're not gonna attack her.
Good move. Look, you want me to come with you? Make it worth my while.
Join my team and I'll do what I can for you.
Don't make promises you can't keep. I bet your ship's got lots of Cerberus databases. I want to look at those files, see what Cerberus has got on me.
No problem, I'll give you whatever you want.
Let me go through those databases.
I'll give you full access.
You better be straight up with me.
Hey, I'm
Shepard. So why the hell are we standing here?
Move out.
I hate when people say that. It's like, so why are we standing here? You know, why are we standing here? We could be on the ship by now. You're the one that stopped us. Recruited prisoner known as Jack for the team. Purgatory's betrayal of Shepard unacceptable. Fortunately, was able to reverse credit transfer. May have to take steps against Blue Suns to demonstrate consequences for interference. Then we got two research options, damage. Not as much credits as the Warlord one, but... you know, we got two upgrades. Kind of balances. Since upgrades cost a heaps. It's like, what, 5,000 per? We didn't even get enough for one upgrade. But we could get two in the balance of upgradeness, if that makes any sense to you.
Welcome to the Normandy, Jack. I'm Miranda, Shepard's second in command. On this ship, we follow orders.
When did I say that?
Tell the Cerberus cheerleader to back off, Shepard. I'm here because of our deal.
Miranda will let you into the system. Let me know what you find.
Hear that, precious? We're going to be friends. You, me, and every embarrassing little secret. I'll be reading down in the hold, or somewhere near the bottom. I don't like a lot of through traffic.
Okay.
Keep your people off me. Better that way.
Miranda's pissed. Sorry, Miranda. I mean, I told you I'm not really pro Cerberus. Jack's not pro Cerberus either. I like it. Need more anti Cerberus. Alright, let's get the shotgun upgrade. Hoo-wee. And I'm pretty sure we also get shield piercing. That's be quite a freak. Quite a fine. And we also get some damage protection. Because we hella need it. Although, we didn't get as wrecked last time. And we get refunded shield generator. Sometimes when Shepherds go down, they are instantly fully restored. I can dig it. Give me that right now. I could actually really use that. Alright, let's go talk to Jack. Actually, let's go talk to Kelly, because Kelly got that info on Jack.
Jack's tattoos are beautiful. As colorful as her past, I'm sure. I have concerns with her temper, though.
What do you mean?
You have worries about Jack?
I know she'll be solid under fire, but her attitude suggests deep personal issues. She pushes people away, yet approaches sex casually. I don't think she understands her own motivations. I wouldn't be surprised if she makes advances on you. If you want her respect, think twice.
I'll be careful.
I'll do my best not to piss her off.
Please warn me if you fail. I want a chance to hide. Anyway, what's up?
That'll be all.
I don't think I'll be able to warn.
The elusive man wishes to speak to you in the debriefing room, Commander.
Ooh. Well, let's check these unread messages. Glad you're okay. From Kate Bowen. Shepard, I called in some favors and found out how to get to you and what you're working on. We've got a big celebration planned for the anniversary of you, and others are saving big anniversary planned for you and the others for saving Terra Nova. Last year we added a memorial for you too. I guess that was premature, huh? I figured finding out who's attacking colonies is why you had to go undercover. So I won't invite you to come give a speech or anything, but I wanted to know that all of us living on the colonies are worried about what's happening in the Terminus system. And I'm really glad you're there to help. There's a lot of crazy military talk going around. I'm glad someone's out there not going to take the easy way out. Thanks, Kate Bowen. So that's talking about how I have the colonist background and how, yeah, Terra Nova is the one that got attacked, right? Yeah. Wait, no. Is that the Skillian Blitz? I think that's the Skillian Blitz one. Or the one that I prevented. As a sole survivor. Whatever. Martin... Ooh, Martin, that's my last name. Martin Burns. Commander Shepard, Udina said this would reach you. I want you to know that I haven't forgotten what you did for me the day those crazy biotics took me hostage. You talked them down and got me off that shit alive. Ship alive. I won't lie to you, I took this job for the pull and the power. I saw the biotics issue as a stepping stone. Something good to put on my resume, and I was wrong. We all serve humanity in our own way, and I don't know what you're doing. But I'm gonna see to it that humanity reaches its potential with minimum bloodshed, and I'm getting letters thanks from the biotic L2 biotics who are receiving their reparation. Those letters should be really coming to you. I thought you should know. Good luck. I've taken some political heat, and I don't know if my offer to help you would ever be useful, but if you need me, I won't let you down. Martin Burns, Chairman, Subcommittee for Transhuman Studies. Okay. First things first, going down to my cabin to feed my fish. It's gonna be a priority after every mission. Gotta feed those fish. Alright, and Jack's at the bottom. I wonder if Grunt wants to talk too. Let's go check out Grunt first. Most companions usually have two talks, but I think Grunt only has one.
Shepard.
Just checking in, making sure you're acclimatizing.
The hold is too open. Good. Not enough cover. Armor is limited. Warlord Granth would target here to scatter heavy cargo, then focus on engines. That's what tank imprints show about human ships anyway. It's how I learned from the tank. Old pictures where memory is.
You're smart.
Like holding a book for a child. Just remember this picture after picture. No help with finding a reason to care.
Any other human imprints?
What other human info is floating around in there?
Less than a finger deep to sever your spine. You're soft. Salarians, Asari, all soft. Quarians, not so much.
Interesting.
Turians, you have to work the blade, I guess. Don't see much point to it, though. Much point. Never mind.
You have no reaction.
Something must move you. You're as genetically Krogan as you can get.
I see suffering, the dead, and I think weak. I'm supposed to be strong. My guts were grown from thousands more worthy. The dead were weak. If they were strong, I wouldn't be needed. I don't know why O'Kear started teaching. When he turned on the tank the first time, I screamed. Weak, pitiful.
And yeah,
so
now
you're
strong.
Small, but you became what you are. Not everyone gets that chance.
I built for strength, but didn't earn it. I just am.
You are strong. You're
Those
just
dead were strong enough to try, even if they lost. The perfect Krogan, ignoring what made me. No strength in that. I'll take another look at what happened to the Krogan. Find a reason to care about it.
Oh, he sees himself as stronger than the Krogan. So much so that he doesn't care about the Krogan, because the Krogan in his eyes are weak, and he is strong. Let's see what Tweedledee.
The new armor reinforcements really threw off the gravimetric profiles. But engines are good to go. I rebalanced the Gilborn coefficients and adjusted the anterior intakes on the second tier stabilizers.
I love it when you talk dirty.
Ken. Ken and Gabby, right? Actually not sure. Hello.
Hey.
Any upgrades?
I picked up a lot of resources. Can you use them to help against the collectors?
I ran across the schematics for making L5X implants. Still got them in my head. You want to know what I need? Not usually my thing, but I've learned how to get things done on my own.
Cool. Considering Shepard is an L3 and Caden is an L... Oh, no, Shepard's an L4, I believe. Caden's an L2. Research subject boost, yes.
Hey.
I picked up a lot of resources. Can you use
I figured out those L5Xs. Consider yourself lucky. It's not like I keep a library of this shit around.
Miranda.
What do you think of Miranda and Jacob?
Jacob doesn't know who he is, but that's not my problem. Miranda's a Cerberus bitch. Knew that before she opened her mouth.
What do you think of our mission?
I don't care. I'm out to survive it, then cut loose.
Tell me about you, Jack.
I'm still finding out about me. Thanks for letting me look at these files.
If they're helping you, that's good enough for me.
Yeah.
Don't be my buddy. You need me to kill for you, I need you for these files. Let's leave it there. Your friends at Cerberus are into some nasty things.
Like
I'm
what?
I'm gonna find something I can use. I just know it.
What if the answers aren't what you expect?
I'm not looking for answers. I'm looking for names, dates, places.
What happens when you find what you're looking for?
I go hunting. Anyone who's screwed with me pays. Their associates pay. Their friends pay. The galaxy's gonna be a lot emptier when I'm done.
What happens when you find what you're looking for?
I go hunting. Their associates pay. Their friends pay.
I won't let you go on a killing spree.
I'm here for your mission. After that, what I do is my business.
What if the answers aren't what you expect?
I'm not looking for answers. I'm looking for names, dates, places.
I thought it said something about a ship, but I guess I'm wrong.
What's your history with Cerberus?
They raised me in a research facility. I escaped when I was a kid. Been on the run ever since. And they've been chasing me ever since. But soon, I'm gonna chase them.
You sound excited?
You think about this a lot, don't you?
I go to sleep with this. I wake up with it. Everyone I kill, I pretend it's the ones that did this to me.
Wow,
you don't have to live in this
really
pit
damaged.
Now.
It's dark, quiet, and hard to find. That spells safety to me. You know, this ship is a powerhouse. You could go pirate. Live like a king. I could help.
We have to stop the collectors. I don't have time for piracy.
When this is done, we'll either be dead or out here in space. With this ship.
Really now?
Think about it. Lots of creds. Freedom to go wherever you want. And all the mayhem and fighting I could want.
What is it about killing that fascinates you so much?
I figure every time someone dies and it's not me, my chances of survival go up.
Alright.
I should go.
You're crazy.
Yep.
Well, alright. Alright. The elusive man wants to talk. I think I'll save that for next thing. What else can I do before I end it? There's nothing really. I could go talk to Kasumi, go check out her quarters. Then I could end the episode. Hello! Next Normandy gets a bar. Do I want to drink it? Ooh, super liquor. Now you drink it. Alright, let's...
That painting has a special place in my heart.
Why?
An art collector hired me to steal it. When I got there, the painting was gone. On the way out, I saw it being hauled off by another thief. I chased him down, tackled him, and took the painting. That's how KG and I met. We never did turn it into our employers.
Well, I mean, it's right there. Is that like Prothean? That looks pretty Prothean, actually.
The Red Rose. That used to be my calling card when I first started out. In place of whatever I took, I left a single Red Rose. It wasn't until I met Keiji that I realized how silly it was. He had a way of making you realize when you were just being sentimental.
There's a guy standing there. One guy. Or is it a girl? It looks more heavy, though, with, like, armor and shit. Can't really tell.
Don't laugh. I like those books. Romance novels, crime novels, the classics. There's something about the feel of actual paper in your hands. Their musty smell. It's relaxing. Keiji used to find books for me while on the job. Some of these are more valuable than the objects he was hired to steal.
Hell, I mean... That's why I have an entire bookshelf. I love books.
That's my favorite piece, painted for me by a child prodigy from Elysium. She was the cutest thing. She was kidnapped by slavers who hoped to sell her on Omega. I wasn't about to let that happen. I set up an idea as a buyer's rep to get a special tour of the slaver's vessel. Once aboard, I freed the girl and smuggled her off the ship. She painted that for me on the way home. I'll never forget how it felt to watch her work.
Rakesh Ragan?
I stole that on a dare, believe it or not. There was a big museum show coming to Ilium. Artifacts from Earth going on tour. Very high security. Keiji dared me to steal this. So I broke in, hacked the security, put a few guards to sleep, and replaced the piece with a worthless duplicate. They never knew the difference. My first museum job. Nowhere near the last.
Cool. Well, I believe that's it.
People are talking out there, and I hear it all. I usually travel hidden away in cargo bays. It's nice to be able to look out a window for a change.
Yeah, I don't think Grunt or Jack would like that.
Mess Sergeant Gardner might just be an evil genius. Emphasis on the evil. The food's gotten better lately, though. I guess his reputation will take time to heal. I'm not really sure what to do with myself. Not much call for thievery aboard a ship. Come back later. I'm sure I'll have more to talk about.
Okay. I'll probably forget to, but okay. Anyways, I'm gonna end this.
The elusive man wishes to speak to you in the debriefing room, Commander.
Yeah. Anyways, I'm gonna end this episode recording session thingy here, and I shall hope to see you in the next one, because we're gonna be dealing with one of the major quests pivotal to our hunt against the collectors. So I shall see you then. Oh wait, I didn't even thank you for watching. I'm sorry. I'd like to thank you for watching, and I hope you stick around for that dearest episode about the next thing that Elusive Man wants to talk about. Anyways, bye-bye!